I wanna make you smile whenever you're sad. Carry you around when your arthritis is bad. All I wanna do is grow old with you. I'll get you medicine when your tummy aches. Build you a fire if the furnace breaks. Oh, it could be so nice growing old with you. I'll miss you, kiss you, give you my coat when you are cold. Need you, feed you, even let you hold the remote control. So let me do the dishes in our kitchen sink. Put you to bed when you've had too much to drink. Oh, I could be the man who grows old with you. I wanna grow with you.
Quite an honor to have her call me and ask if I could perform this service today. Marriage is a special, God-given event. God immediately noticed that it was not good for man to be alone, and he created woman and declared, "For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother and cleave unto his wife, and the two shall be one flesh." Literally two individuals becoming one in God's sight. I'm so honored to be able to serve today God and his people, and Sam and my family. But it's important to note that it's not I that joined them today, but it is the Lord Jesus Christ who's speaking right now. Mike and Sam, you come to begin your new life together today. The life includes each other forever. And there'll be stormy times, and there'll be good times. Have you both carefully considered the commitment that you're about to make and believe that it's by God's divine will that you be joined together?
Yes.
You sure?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Some say that marriage is a 50-50 proposition, and I disagree. In order for a marriage to work, both will have to give each other 100%. Marriage requires the kind of love that gives unselfishly, willingly, and sacrificially. The kind of love that Jesus Christ showed for us when he sacrificed himself on Calvary for our sins, so that those who accept his gift of eternal life would not have to die. When the Apostle Paul described the love between two people in a marriage, he used Christ's love for the church as an example, one willing to die for the other. Many poets and songwriters have tried over the years, but no one describes love like the author of that love in 1 Corinthians 13, where God's word says love is patient, love is kind, does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it is not rude, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no records of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. If you love someone, you're loyal to them no matter the cost. You'll always believe in them and always stand your ground in their defense. Love makes burdens lighter because now you divide them, and it makes life more intense when you share them. Marriage is a covenant between a man, a woman, and God Almighty. Let's start. Lord, we just come before you right now, and we ask, Lord, that you would just bless this union. And Lord, we know that Satan is doing his best right now to dampen our spirits, Lord, but we rejoice in your love and the love that you placed in these two people's hearts for each other. And so, Lord, we stand under your protective hand, and we come before you to bring honor and glory to your name through this union in Christ's name. Your hands for the giving of your vows of commitment to each other. Mike, will you take Sam to be your wife? You promise to love her and comfort her in sickness and in health, while forsaking all others, keeping only to her so long as you both shall live. Sam, will you take Mike to be your husband? You promise to love him, to hold him, to comfort him in sickness and in health, while forsaking all others, as long as you both shall live. Mike, repeat after me, please. I might take these things.
I might take these things.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have the hope.
To have the hope.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or worse.
For better or worse.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
Sam, repeat after me, please. I, Sam, take thee, Mike.
I, Sam, take thee, Mike.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or worse.
For better or worse.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or
poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish.
To love and to
cherish. Until death do us part. I think this is going to be a fun marriage. Now Mike and Sam will seal their vows to each other with the exchanging of the rings. The wedding ring is a symbol of the marriage in at least two ways. One, the purity of the metal represents the purity of the love that you have for each other right now. And secondly, the unending circle symbolizes your unending love for each other. Mike, place the ring on Sam's finger and repeat after me. With this ring, I pledge my love and my loyalty for heaven.
I pledge my love and loyalty for heaven.
Sam, place your next finger hands and feet. With this ring, I pledge my love and loyalty to you forever. Mike and Sam are now going to light the, well, we're going to explain the Unity Candle, and then they're going to share in the Lord's Supper. The Unity Candle is representative of the one life that they now begin together. But the two candles on the outside are not intended to be extinguished, for those two families still exist. They only expand and grow, and Mike and Sam begin another family today.
There you go, look at that.
That is not symbolic in any way. Yourselves to each other in the presence of friends, family, and God today. You've shared in your first Lord's Supper. You began a new family and a new life, and I pray that you'll always keep Christ in the center of your marriage and your home and live in the fullness of His blessings forever. To help each other, one another, to become all they can in Christ, to be each other's helpmate. The time has come for you to begin your new life together in the holy bonds of marriage. Therefore, seeing that you have made this commitment to each other before God and this company of witnesses, I, according to the laws of the state and the power of God, pronounce you husband and wife. Therefore, God is part of God, and no man can do this under. You may kiss your bride. And I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Mike Calise.
Closer to you. Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Dobson Ranch House and this beautiful occasion of why we've all gathered here tonight. At this time, everybody is standing, so that's a good thing. How is everybody? Ladies and gentlemen, big smiles. We're going to introduce some fun people here for you. Starting off with the bridesmaids. Here they are, Mr. and Mrs. Charles Lunsford. Come on, let's receive each couple with a nice round of applause. Equally nice round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for the bride's dad. Here he is, Mr. Bob Johnson, escorted by Debbie. Let's give them a nice round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. How about a nice round of applause for our groom's mom? Here she is, Miss Lisa Calise, escorted by Bob. Come on, let's give them a nice round of applause. Here's the groom's dad. Here they are, Mr. and Mrs. Michael Calise. Come on, let's give them a nice round of applause. No bridal party would be complete without our beautiful bridesmaids and handsome ushers. Tonight is no exception. Starting off with Ashley and Jason. Come on, Ashley and Jason. Nice round of applause. Equally nice round of applause for Christy and Chris and Little Nick. Come on, let's hear it for all of those guys. Keep that round of applause going for Ashley and Travis. Okay, here's our little flower girls. Oh, this is Rebecca and AJ. Ladies and gentlemen, nice round of applause for Rebecca and AJ. Nobody, bridal party would be complete without our best man and maid of honor. Here they are, Daniel and Brianna. Come on, let's hear it for Daniel and Brianna. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the reason why we've all gathered here tonight, let's start that round of applause right now for the first time as husband and wife. Here they are, Mr. and Mrs. Michael, please come on, let's hear it for them. Ladies and gentlemen, put those hands together. Gentlemen, they've chosen a beautiful song for their first dance as husband and wife. Here they are. It's When You Say Nothing at All by Alison Krauss. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for our bride and groom. Put your hands together for our bride and groom. Join them in the first dance as husband and wife. Once again, the entire bridal party, please.
Being said between you.
husband and wife, would like to invite you all out onto the dance floor.
Yes, when she was giving her, you know, I do's, It was so natural. You know, it was natural. She loves her.
So I think your marriage isn't going to be as fun as you are.
Yes.
So
you have nothing to say?
Best wishes and
happiness. Oh, there's my girls.
We came out from Connecticut just for this wedding.
Oh, wow.
And we're having a wonderful time. We wish them many, many years of happiness together. Okay?
Thank you.
Hey, guys. I just want to say good luck with being married, and I wish you lifelong happiness. And have fun on your honeymoon, and I know everything will go great because you guys go perfect together, and you're meant for each other and stuff. So, good luck.
You're on.
Hi, Mikey. Hi, Sam. Just wanted to wish you a big congratulations. We love you both. We are very proud of you. Much love, much happiness forever and ever.
My advice is just never go to bed angry with each other. Work it out. Love you.
We love you guys.
We're Mikey and Sam. I hope you have a wonderful life together and give me lots of great grandchildren.
Happiness always, Mikey and Sam.
Yeah, I'm Mikey. I want to push you best wishes because we really love you.